like to talk to you about a beautiful, small but beautiful institution of Los Angeles culture, which you might know already, maybe you're not so familiar with that, Musica Angelica Baroque Orchestra. I have to talk a little bit about my own biography, not too much, and afterwards we're going to give you an example of the style of music we are producing with our period instruments, I would say if you look at the orchestra world today, you have large symphony orchestras, you have chamber orchestras, and since the 1970s, I would say there's a big trend to period instrument ensembles or orchestra, which means groups who said, okay, the orchestra world has developed to a modern situation, but the music of Mozart, Haydn, Bach, Handel was played with a different hardware, we could say, different instruments than we use today. And people got interested and started to play these old trumpets, which you might know from paintings in Baroque churches, which look like fanfares, or like the French ones, which don't have any walls, or the violins with gut strings. And in the beginning, it sounded awful, because in the beginning, they had to experience how do we train these instruments, how do we work with these instruments. But over the years, became something which became really important for the music world. And today, let's say a young musician entering a university or who wants to get a job in a symphony has to have both experiences. He has to know how to play the modern violin, he has to know how to play the violin with gut strings, or he has to know how to play a modern trumpet and a baroque trumpet. And so, it started in Europe a little bit before the United States that orchestras grew who used these original baroque instruments. And I started in Vienna in 1985, a group which started very small and then became really a symphony orchestra. In Vienna, the competition was a little bit bigger than it's over here because Vienna is a city of 1.8 million. We have six symphony orchestras, we have three opera houses playing every night. And when I started this baroque orchestra, Nina Academy, everybody said, Philharmonic said, why? We don't need you, we can do that. And then they started to find out it helps everybody. Yeah? We get these informed performances, and it's not a competition anymore, it's just an addition to the music world. And in Vienna, my Viennese orchestra plays in the Golden Hall, the Music Frame, the same hall where they have the New Year's concert. We have 1,500 subscribers, and it's flourishing. We're doing opera, and we're playing a lot. For me, to work in America was since my early youth a dream, and I worked. I had my first teaching position at the Midwestern University in the late 1970s and so on, and I came to Los Angeles here in the early 1980s to work at the Arnold Schoenberg Institute at UC and so on. And in around 2000, I had a series of conducting gigs with major symphonies. I conducted San Francisco, here the Hollywood Bowl, the LA Philharmonic and so on. And then I got this invitation to conduct this baroque orchestra in Los Angeles. Phone call and said, okay, let's do it. And it turned out, I found out later, that Musica Angelica was a small chamber music group, five people, with a charismatic leader, Michael Egan, who played the lute. And they got some support from the Colburn Institution. And I conducted my first concert at Sipo Hall Colburn, and Mr. Richard Colburn was still alive. And I remember he came. I went to him to Israel and he said, they would use you here, or they can use you here, but you have to promise me don't play any music after Beethoven. And he said, okay, I'm a modern music guy, I do a lot of modern music, but with this group we can concentrate on the early stuff. That's it. And then I decided for me it's more interesting to build something which is growing to come back to the same group than to guest conduct always to travel around and to be with the orchestra only once or twice over the years. You cannot change anything, but if you work with one group, you can get knowledge, you can get experience, and so on. And so, after the years, Musica Angelica became really a group which is wind players who come from the East Coast out here. At the same time, the members of this group are alienating the local musicians to get used more and more to these quality instruments. And for me, this is very important. In Europe, I see the mixture has happened already. Almost every violinist who sits in the orchestra has had some experience with baroque music, with period instruments. Over here, it's still a little bit more. Right? You have the symphonies, and the symphonies, we don't need that. And then we have these baroque players who are coming from another world, yeah, but who are doing in some ways the same music. Yeah? And for me, I want to build these bridges, and for me, this work here, I come to Los Angeles, I would say, 6 or 7 times a year. We work with this orchestra, with the chamber orchestra. This work is very interesting, very rewarding, and I see it, we can build bridges. I conduct, when I come back in May, I conduct the LA Chamber Orchestra with a similar program. And for me, this is not a question of either or. You can inspire every musician. And hardware, our instruments, are one part. Music happens in the soul and in the head. And if you know how to do it, how to experience, then every orchestra can make beautiful music. And for us, I see a lot of possibilities for Musica Angelica with the support of the local community, of the local people. We are flexible, we are versatile. One example, we would like to explore a little bit more downtown Los Angeles possibilities. So we started to do our concerts in downtown Los Angeles at the AT&T Center Theater, which is a building which was not used for the arts since a long time. We discovered that this room does work very well, so we have some of our concerts in this hall. Or another experience, we're doing baroque opera in the next season. We're doing a production of Aces in Galatea, which is a very beautiful Handel opera, in an outdoor production. So I was using 2 days ago to travel around where our venues, where you have a beautiful home, a lawn in front of it, where you can do outdoor performances of Aces in Galatea. Or another thing, outreach programs. Our musicians are highly qualified, not only as performers, but also as teachers. So the connection with the university is very important, with Colburn School, with UC, with UCLA. Or even the connection, we have the idea to go to different homes to offer concerts where the instruments are explained. How can you play a trumpet with it's not a single waterfall there, just with your lips? Or what is the difference of the baroque violin to the modern violin? What is the repertoire and so on? Part of our work is local, and it's very important, and I have a beautiful board and staff to support it. We are a small institution. We need energy, we need funds, we need to grow, to get the message out what we are doing. And a lot of our work is international. So, Musica Angelica has toured Europe twice already. We have toured South America twice. We have a very interesting project, 2 music theater projects with the actor John Malkovich, which we bring to all parts of the world. We are going, for instance, to this project to Mexico in April or to South America in August. So, musicians and Musica Angelica people are very active. So if you are more and more interested, what can we do? We have the season brochure here. We will have our next season brochure out very soon. There are some concerts this weekend. For instance, we have a Bach program with 2 wedding cantatas by G.S. Bach and Wagner Concerto and Oboe Concerto. So we try to play our program almost twice here in the area, once downtown or Pasadena, and once in West Los Angeles or Santa Monica. So our home is Santa Monica, but we would like to cover the area here. So my idea was, when I came here, to help to build this institution, that again, Vienna, 6 symphonies, 4 chamber orchestras, 2 baroque orchestras. The other one for the music lovers is Nikolaus Hamburg, the Concertus Musicus, who was the grandfather of all baroque orchestras in some ways. Here we have LA Philharmonic, we have LA Chamber Orchestra, and I would say for the baroque music, it can be musical jazz. So there's still room for expansion. I would say Vienna has 1.8 million. Here we have something like 15 million. So I think there's hope that growth is possible. We can expand. We can expand very much.